I mean, my first question to you would be about the brand objectives and challenges that you wanted to tackle through advertising on TV during IPL.
During IPL, okay. Fine. So, firstly, I think, you know, if you go back to 2018, when we started our first association with IPL, you know, as a brand, we were in the middle of a turnaround in terms of brand perception. And we had a lot of new products in the anvil about to be launched. And at that point of time, the thinking was, which is the best platform on around which we can, you know, popularize our launches. And that's when IPL came to our mind, and we began the discussion with BCCI. We thought it's a very good platform to, you know, really deliver a great level of reach and visibility across the country. And we've also started mapping our launches around IPL. Every year you'll see that we had a new product being launched and being associated with IPL. It started off with Nexon in 2018. Then we moved to the Harrier. And last year it was the Altroz. So fortunately we could align our launches along with every year's IPL. And we thought it would give a very good, I would say, launching pad for our new products. And by help really accelerate that brand perception, transformation in brand perception of Tata Motors. When it comes to cricket obviously is a religion in India, one of the most followed and most celebrated kind of sport. And within cricket, IPL obviously is one of the biggest properties. In fact, it would not be wrong to say that IPL is now the single largest media property across all genres in India, and not only sports, but across all genres. We've seen that during the IPL, even movie releases are delayed. And there's nothing which happens. So for us, you know, it made a lot of sense to partner with IPL with what we think is one of the biggest media platforms in the country.
How would you evaluate the qualitative reach of IPL? I mean, the quality of reach that it offers, say the attention span or the opportunity to see, or you know, how much attention do you grab during the breaks?
Yeah, good question. In fact, qualitative reach is one of the reasons why we went with IPL in 2018. I think it was 2018 where Star Sports got transmission rights for IPL.
Yeah.
And their approach was very different. And the biggest difference which appealed to us was that they were focusing on regional a lot. You know? Okay. So, you know, Star Sports has actually got 7 different streams of transmission. And what happens with this, regional approach is that it goes very deep into each of the different regions. And also it attracts a lot of diverse viewership. You know, cricket used to be predominantly male viewing, but with IPL and this really good approach by Star Sports, it has become a family viewing IPL, actually. Yeah. And to be appreciated also is that it's not just that the, you know, a superficial regional approach. I think the kind of stream, the editing of the visuals, the commentary teams are also locally sourced, relevant commentary teams for that particular region. So it's very, very comprehensive approach. And that, along with the event itself, it's the style in which Star Sports is taking the event to the public is what really attracted us. So qualitatively, very good. We are able to reach deep into each region of the country. It's not like GEC, which is predominantly north and east, whereas it is a great combination of sports and general entertainment.
So what were the elements of your TV campaign with IPL? I'm talking specifically of the TV campaign here.
It's a good, because IPL is a very different format. Obviously, you have more than, if I remember right, close to 70 odd matches. And every match, I think we have about 4 or 5 TV spots, you know. And if you run that same ad for such frequency, it's going to be extremely boring for customers. So from our side, you know, you don't want to see the same ad 282 300 times as a customer, right? There's a huge amount of irritation and frustration that will come in. So with regard to our TV approach, we've kind of really stretched the envelope in terms of creative. We had specific IPL-based advertising done for these products.
Let's talk about the impact of the association and what the TV campaign achieved for you.
Yeah, so at a brand level, while we have several brand KPI in terms of awareness consideration, but the one thing we really focus upon is Net Promoter Score, NPS, which we think is a comprehensive KPI which covers all aspects of the brand. Tata Motors has been consistently growing in NPS, but the IPL has actually turbocharged our growth in terms of NPS. Thanks to the IPL, of course, there are several other factors, but we think IPL has added a certain level of aspiration and speed to the brand. And from a level of around 7th ranking, we have moved now to number 3 in NPS score across the automotive category. And I think a lot of credit for that should go to our presence in IPL.
Okay. And talking about the business objectives now, like post the campaign, the television campaign on IPL, did you see any surge in, say, inquiries, booking, sale?
Yeah, for sure. So inquiries and bookings and web visits have consistently gone up for all the products. IPL is an awareness building platform is how we look at it, you know. So more and more people should get aware of the product brand name, and we track that by the level of Google searches and the level of web visits that we get. And today I'm happy to say that every product that has been associated with IPL, the Nexon, the Harrier and the Altroz, have become pillar products for us. And together, if you see our market share, we've consistently grown. Today, we are sitting around 8.5% market share for the year. And and this has been a consistent growth over the last 3 years. But more important message, I would say, is you know, the kind of brand pillars that we have built around Nexon, Altroz, and Harrier is thanks to IPL.